an accord, and there is a stabilization in that society. Yeah. That's why you got red lights and green lights and stop signs. Amen. And you got all kind of ordinances. Mm-hmm. You break one to see. Amen. If they want, they'll do. They'll put you in jail or fine you.
Amen.
Police stopped me the other night. Mm-hmm. For no reason. I'm driving along. I saw him pull behind. I said, he's going to stop me. Sure enough, followed me a couple miles and stopped me. He said, you got your driver's license insurance? I said, yes. He said, you know why I stopped me? Why I stopped me? I said, no. No, I have the slightest idea. I know it wasn't speeding. He said, well, you're in 55 miles at a zone, and you're in the left lane and at the right lane. How's somebody going to pass you? I said, well, if I'm doing 55, how's somebody going to pass me anyhow without breaking the law? He said, well, I'm going to issue a warning ticket. You don't have to pay it. It's just a warning. I said, thank you.
That's right.
You devil, you. I said, the devil's in my heart. In my heart. I'm showing you what we're up against, church. The world is so corrupted now. Until if you're not under the blood covering, you will never be able to escape. Because God is angry now, and any moment, God's going to spit that sky, and he's going to wipe out all this filth that you see. These people are riding high.
That's right.
Totally have no regard to the word of God.
That's right.
God said he made male and female.
That's right.
What is this homosexualness we mess going about? And to high position in government and crying out for more rights and more rights and more. What kind of rights do you want? You know what they want? They want a position of authority where they can close a church down.
Right. Yeah.
What the Bible said, the gates of hell should not be there. That's the church. So we have to understand, when the battle gets hot, you got to hear a message from heaven. And the word is a message if you have enough faith to receive it. Also understand that in a battle, sometimes the victory is not really established until the battle gets hot.
That's right.
There got to be some sure enough slugging going on.
That's right.
When we see that we are done, we've done all we can do,
amen.
And you've planted your feet to obey the word of God,
amen.
Don't worry about what you are going through.
Right.
It ain't nothing but a battle. Amen. And regardless of how hot the battle gets, when it gets too hot, God's going to step in and give you the victory. Praise God. Now, again, you see here it says, speak great words against the Most High, and shall what?
Wear out the saints of the Most High.
Now, here's the part I want you to watch.
And think to change times and laws.
Yes. Yes. You're going to change times and laws. Mr. Obama, you can't change the law.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
You cannot make a homosexual a lesbian, a male and female. You can't do that. I don't care how you legalize homosexual marriage. They're not married in the sight of God. They're deviates.
That's right.
Strange.
Yes.
That's right.
Misfits.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Yes. Not normal.
Yes. Prophet preach.
Abnormal.
Yes.
Doing that which is against your nature.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And you're going to try to make it normal?
Preach.
Pass your laws and get your decrees all you want.
Yes.
But it's still wrong.
Yes.
And I'm going to still preach out against it.
Yes.
All you coward pastors out there.
That's right.
You support this lesbian homosexual movement. Why don't you stop and think, what in the world is going on here?
Amen.
What is going on?
Amen.
All this mess about a man wanting to be a woman wanting to be a man. What is going on here?
Amen.
And how many, 1,000,000.3 babies murdered in the slaughterhouses last year?
Amen.
And the number surpassed mid-October. I think we're close to mid-October now.
Amen.
What is going on here?
Amen.
Where is the sense of realization of what is taking place?
Amen.
When man separates himself so far from God,
yeah.
A reality of what is right and wrong no longer has any precedence.
Amen.
Whenever you do not know the difference between what is right and wrong, then you're in a position to do wrong all the time.
Yes, yes.
And then the time will come, as the Bible said, you'll start calling right wrong and wrong right.
Right.
And we're in that time right now.
Amen.
So we've got to hold on and fight this good fight of faith and not get weak.
Yes.
Church, honey, don't you dare get discouraged. You maintain the standard that God set in this book, because this book is going to prevail. This book is not going to be destroyed.
Right.
Don't your leg in discouragement. You keep your head up when you got your veil coming on. Daughter testified how she went to the mall and they accused her of being a Muslim. When they found out she was a Christian, that's when they started cursing.
Yes.
I guess they wouldn't curse if she said, "Yeah, I'm a Muslim."
Mm-hmm.
All right. We are faced with these situations. They'll mock you. They'll scorn you. Mm-hmm. Might even hit you.
Yes.
Hope they don't.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. Hope they don't hit the wrong one.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
But we're faced with these conditions. You have to solidify yourself knowing who you are
Yes.
in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
And they are changing the law of God.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe, what did you say?
Mm-hmm.
Verse 25.
Mm-hmm.
To think to change the laws of God.
And they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time.
Now, the dividing of times has come.
Yes.
That's why God told me, he said, don't pray for the world.
Yes.
Pray for the remnant church.
Amen.
Pray for those who have got a mind to want to be saved.
Right.
Let's pray for each other and strengthen each other.
Okay.
Now, when I say this, you never stop praying for your family members.
Right.
Because that's a part of you. So we pray for our family members.
Amen.
But what I'm saying, we don't pray for the abject world. We don't pray for, well, bless this one. He voted for homosexual and lesbian marriage, but we still going to pray for him. No, I don't believe in that.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes.
That time is past.
Yes.
We're going to pray for somebody not to want to accept to be a homosexual
That's
or
right.
lesbian.
That's right.
And if they are that way, repent.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. And God will wash you white in his side and bring you into the household of faith and plant your feet on a solid rock. This is disgraceful what is taking place here. Another lesbian appointed to a high position. They just appointed a homosexual to a school board in charge of all federal schooling. Appointed here just last week. What is he doing? He's not going to stop. I told you a few weeks ago. The lesbian agenda is to take over America and thusly control the whole world through the central figure that is the person in the representative of the Antichrist who will control and govern the one world system of government, what the world is heading to now.
Amen.
That's why you got all these wars to control under a central leadership that God predicted, the man of sin.
Yes.
I don't know who he is, but I'm saying, keep watching.
That's right.
You can't hide a person's character.
That's right.
And you can't hide their true nature. Anytime someone is so, and getting ready to pass a law to allow homosexuals into the military service.
That's right. God forbid.
That's right.
Can you imagine a sissy in the Marine Corps?
That's right.
Hey man, I'm telling like it is. Praise God.
Yes,
a sissy in the 101st Airborne. I believe they call them the Screaming Eagles. I had friends who was in it. 82nd Airborne, most decorated outfit in World War II. And sissy's gonna be fighting beside you. Lucia.
That's right.
Sisters on the football team.
Not for me, man.
Should be a line somewhere.
Amen.
There's a place for women and a place for men, and there's no place for sisters.
Yeah.
No. Hallelujah. Praise be to God for the Lord. Now, can I get to my text?
Preach, Prophet.
1 Samuel. Chapter 11.
Amen.
Verse 9.
And they said unto the messengers that came, thus shall ye say unto the men of Jabesh Gilead, tomorrow, by that time the sun be hot, ye shall have help.
Now, here, they are faced with the enemies that surround it. So, they sent for help from King Saul, who at this time has favor with God.
Amen.
And Saul tries to explain to them, when the going gets hot, that's when you're going to get the victory.
Yes.
I'm trying to let you know, church, no matter what you're going through, the more intense the struggle within you and the world, the quicker you're going to get the victory.
Hallelujah.
So you need to tell the devil, bring it on.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm ready for